direction, no place to be. High on emotions, just you and me. So like the fire deep inside, it doesn't matter where we're going. We're going. Ultraviolet deep desires, I just wanna see you glowing. Glowing, you know. These days are golden, golden, and our hearts won't be broken. Broken, we'll stay forever young, just hold. Welcome to Japan Language Factory Membership Program. Today is Writing 1. So, first time today we will write little bit long sentences. Okay? And especially today is an introduction. So, you can use very much, very useful when you meet Japanese people or when you met Japanese people in the social media. Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, YouTube, whatever. When you meet, hello, nice to meet you. My name is Terumi. I am studying Japanese and I like Japan because of da 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 da. Then, oh really? I like too. Oh, we are same. Let's be a friend or something like this. So, of course, you can introduce yourself. Then you will have a lot of Japanese friends maybe. Something like this. I'm here in Greece. I made Greek friends and I can speak English and I made friends all over the world. That's amazing. That's the language and you can do so many things. So, today is introduction. Okay? And then this is my introduction. So, of course, you can make your introduction and steal my idea and you should make your own introduction. And if you really want make the strong introduction about you, of course, join my lesson, live streaming, and you can ask me anything you want, and we can make your introduction together. Okay? So, today, first of all, my lesson doesn't have any alphabet like English. So, first, try to memorize the hiragana, and after that, try to exercise hiragana, and after that, you can try to make the sentences. Okay, so here, can you read? So hiragana 46, and now you can write down the sentences. So I will read. Konnichiwa. Konnichiwa. What does it mean? Konnichiwa. Konnichiwa. Good afternoon. If you introduce yourself in the morning, it will be Ohayou gozaimasu. So, I introduce myself in the morning. Ohayou gozaimasu. I introduce myself in the evening. Konbanwa. Yes. Okay. These greeting also, please check the greeting lesson. Okay. So, konnichiwa. Good afternoon. 私の名前は So, 私の my 名前 name is Kai Terumi desu. It is polite. Desu is a polite. So, Kai Terumi. Kai is my family name and Terumi is my given name. So, you have to say a family name first. Okay? So, Kai, my family name. Then after that, given name, Terumi desu. So, my name, so 私の, my name is Kai, family name, Terumi, given name, desu. It is polite. And, 出身, 出身, pronunciation, 出身. 出身 means hometown. I'm from where? I'm from means hometown. Where I born? 出身は 日本の, in Japan, 日本の, the country name first, 山梨. 山梨 is my hometown, the name, okay? And Ken desu. Ken means prefecture. So maybe it can be, if you're living in the US, there will be maybe states like California, Americano, California です. Or maybe if you're living in the UK, will be イギリスのロンドンです。Yeah, アメリカのカリフォルニアです。Or if you're living in the Netherlands, オランダのアムステルダムです。Something.Then, if you want to put this prefecture, because I'm not sure your country, you know, what is the prefecture, and or state, or city, or something. So, Yamanashi is a prefecture, so I said, Yamanashi prefecture. So, 日本の in Japan, 日本の Yamanashi 県です. This is my hometown, that is where I am from, is 日本の Yamanashi 県です. So, that's, you can customize.For yourself, okay? So, 今 means now, right now. Now, 今34歳です。I am 34 years old. So, 歳 is years old. So, you have to know the number, so you can check the number lesson. So, 今 now 34歳です。34 years old. 日本語の先生です。I didn't write I am because this sentence flow is about talking about myself. So I don't need to say I am. This is in Japanese not necessary. You can say just I am Terumi. Then if I said 私の名前は then you don't need to say again 私の my. If your sentence has many character like my something and my younger sister, my younger brother and my cousin and my relative something. If your sentence has a many like a character, then you can say that is me, so 私の. But now is only talking about myself, so I don't need to say 私は. It's be just too much in Japanese, so you don't need to say so.I said, I'm 34 years old. Like, my name is Terumi Kai, 34 years old, and Japanese teacher, and hobby is like this. You don't need to say my hobby, I am 34, and I am Japanese teacher. You don't need to say. That's the natural way to speak in Japanese. So, now I'm 34 years old, 34 歳 years old です。日本語のJapanese language, so that's Nihon means Japan. So Go is language. So if you want to say Greek language, will be Girisha Go. If you are German, then Doitsu Go. German language, Doitsu Go. Or Italian, Italia Go. So the country name is Go. So Nihongo no my Japanese language.Teacher. So because I am the Japanese language teacher, so that's why I introduce myself. 日本語の先生です。Japanese language teacher. 趣味は? 趣味 means hobby. Hobby. So because of my introduction, I want to talk about my hobby. To find a similar person that who has a same like a hobby, for example. Then, or maybe same anime you like, whatever.So I want to talk about hobbies. So I said, 趣味は, my hobby is 音楽鑑賞. 音楽 means music. And 鑑賞 is listening or watching. So you can say, if you want to say watching a movie, will be 映画鑑賞. Because 映画 is movie. 映画. But 音楽 is music. 音楽鑑賞です.Listening music, or watching movie can be, okay, 映画 is movie, 音楽 is music. So, 音楽鑑賞です. Listening music, so my hobby is listening music. Hey, let's listen together. So, 特に means especially, because I said my hobby is listening music, and what kind of music, classic music, rock music, whatever. Then I said,Especially, electronic dance music が大好きです. So I like EDM, electronic dance music. So, electronic dance music. All this, you can say classic, classic, rock music, then rock music or rock, or house, like house, whatever, you can put some specifically you like the music if you want. So then, electronic dance music が大好きです。So, you remember that these words is from foreign things. So, everything katakana. So, let's study katakana. So, you can write down your classic music, rock music, all this category is everything usually katakana. Except like Japanese music. For example, like enka. Like this Japanese, like a traditional like music or like a song, you say enka, it's everything hiragana or kanji. Okay, but if like European something music will be everything katakana, so you will write down in katakana. So let's memorize katakana also. And ga, so 大好きです。大好き is I love something, so that's you can steal my idea. Something が大好きです means I love something. For example, if you want to say I love the car and 車が大好きです. I love the pen, then ペンが大好きです. So something が大好きです means I love something. So something が大好きです. Okay, that's so simple and you can use your introduction. So 皆さん, 皆さん means everyone. Hey everyone, 皆さん, 趣味は何ですか? What is your hobby? So, you know, I introduce myself to the audience or maybe university like an enroll exam or a company interview, whatever. So like,皆さん, everyone, what is your hobby? That's I just talk to the audience. So, 皆さん, everyone, 趣味は hobby, because hobby is here. Hobby is music. 皆さん, everyone, 趣味 is what? 趣味 is what? So, what is your hobby? I don't need to say your hobby or my hobby. You know, it's question is you. And...Talking about myself is my. So, Japanese language, this is a very big difference between like English and Japanese that you don't need to say my something or your something or her something or him, his something. You need to see the flow from the flow that, okay, this is a question, so that's talking to me. And this is not a question, so talking about this guy, for example. Of course, if you want to specify it,Or if you want to make emphasize, then you can say anata, you, or my, watashi. But sometimes if you just use too much, then just sounds too much, very strong. So usually you don't need to say 趣味は何ですか? What is your hobby? And また, and 好きな食べ物はSo let's talk about my hobby. Favorite things. Favorite food. 好きな means favorite. So this is also you can use this my idea. Favorite something. So for example, favorite music. 好きな音楽. 好きな食べ物. 好きな something. So favorite food. Food is 食べ物 is food. Food. So 好きな音楽.Favorite music or favorite whatever you can say. A favorite anime. 好きなアニメ. Favorite anime. So, 好きな食べ物. Favorite food is ラーメンです. I love ramen. Yeah. So, then my favorite food is ラーメン. It is very polite. Okay. And 今度. 今度 means...Next time, near future, next time, 今度, next time, or near future, 一緒に, together, 一緒に, together. ラーメン屋に行きませんか? Shall we go to the ramen shop together? That is my ending, you know, introduction. So So what is a hobby? If you like, that is the same hobby do you have? If you have, let's go to the ramen shop together. That's my really beginner introduction. So that's 一緒に together. Ramen 屋. Ramen 屋 is a ramen 屋 shop. Ramen shop. に to this place, to the ramen shop. 行きませんか? You can steal this my idea. 行きませんか is shall we go? Shall we go? So let's go. So shall we go to something? You can use. For example, shall we go to the bookstore? Then 本屋に行きませんか? Somewhere に行きませんか? Is shall we go somewhere? Okay? And よろしくお願いします. Nice to meet you. Thank you for listening. Thank you for your cooperation. Thank you in advance, whatever. Like nice to meet you. I want to meet you more like this. So that's my first introduction. How was it? So, memorizing hiragana. Memorizing katakana. And learn the particle, which is the first grammar. Then, that's it. You can start writing some sentences. This is, if you focus, you can do in 1 month. That's so simple, okay? If you focus, you can do in 1 month, definitely. So, 頑張りましょう!